I mix what I like, what I like, what I like, what I like, what I like. I mix what I like, 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 what I like.
Jared.
Yeah.
Jared, can I add something just a little
Please.
Bit just a little bit off of this point. And I want to go back to what Zach was saying earlier about a response. It was important, and I thought it was important that we do have a response to what came out. And this conversation verifies how important that response was. The acknowledgement of this book so far, and I think it'll continue to be acknowledged, as a response has been noted. We're like 1/1,000,000th of the size of that publisher, you know? But the work you guys did and all the work you guys contributed to actually made this happen. And that will live on as a response. I want to note, though, that in addition to our work, not only did we feel it important, I'm saying as
That's
a
right. group,
Third World Press did too.
Mm-hmm.
So and we had no coordination on this. Initially, I did not know that Third World Press was going to work on a response. They didn't know that we were working on a response. We found that out later. For the record, though, I want to note that Jared, Todd, you guys set an editorial direction that was different than Third World Press.
Yeah.
And that editorial direction was to take on and critically challenge Manning's book. Third World Press and Herb Boyd, they took a different one, and I think just as important. They approached the subject as a balance. They looked at those people who were in favor of the book, those people who were opposed to the book, and brought those together. It's significant that both of those, Third World Press and Black Classic Press, as precarious as our existence has been, still were the ones, because no white press has done this. No white
That's
press,
right.
Still were the ones to offer a type of response and a critique to this major work that may be fiction or fictive, but I was thinking about this, Todd. Even if we go with it, that it's fiction, one of the things we got to say is the greatest piece of fiction that's ever been because I was listening to everybody on the call. I think every person on this call, and certainly all the people, most of the people that I know politically, had their lives changed or touched or moved in some significant way by Malcolm X's book.
And by that's right.
So I just wanted to add that dimension to it. And I want to tell you guys, this is a story too. I don't know how many people remember, but this is to integrity, right? And Jared had the trust to bring this to me. Ta-Nehisi had written a piece on Malcolm X. He was doing more a piece on Obama and Malcolm, and he was citing, he got an early draft of Manning's book. That was initially going to be included in this book. But as the work went along, I think it was, it didn't take that long, a month or two or something. Like Jared and Todd brought up the issue, and they actually thought I would have a problem, I think, with it, because they had to be delicate to tell me that, well, Ta-Nehisi's piece was not critical enough, so it wasn't going to make the cut.
I mean, we figured the way I remember it is we figured if we were already, you know, our heads were already on the chopping block, why not go ahead and go all the way with it? Like, I mean, you know, it was difficult. I remember it being difficult, but at the same time, I mean, it would have been more difficult, I think, to not bring it up and to live with that, because we did want to set that editorial direction. But we were also responding to you, because your first call to me, Paul, was hot.
I'm
not in your inner circle. I'm not in your, you know, but I've been around you enough, and I don't see you blowing up like, I don't see emoting like that. No. And in that call, you were like, look, man,
no.
Like, really? and to Baba Zach's point, you mentioned the Clark response to Styron and said you wanted this to be in that tradition. And I was, and that was like, that's pushing all of my buttons right there. So I was like, it was like, ding, ding. I was so anyway.
For those of you who don't know, John Clark asked me to republish that book, and we did republish it.
That's right.
We published it. Okay. So he wanted the name changed, and the name was The Second Crucifixion.
That's
of
right.
Nat Turner.
Yeah.
So that was done, you know, sometime before he died. And Jared, you're right. I do remember, definitely remember that. I just think the leadership you and Todd exhibited in selecting the folks and setting the editorial direction for this piece, it makes it a hallmark and sets it among, and we all should be grateful for our association on this. So I just thank you guys.
I mix what I like, what I like, what I like, what I like, what I like. I mix what I like, what I like, what I like, what I like, what I like.